Sydney, last year obviously a hard year as far as injuries go. How's that going? Are you fully healthy, and are you looking forward to having a year where that's not imminent?
Yes, I mean, part of the game, you deal with injuries here and there, and so I've been fortunate throughout my career to not really have to deal with too many. But injuries can also be blessings, and I learned a lot, and I think the next step as a professional, because you have the basketball down, you sort of understand what you need in that regard to be successful and to set yourself up. But I personally struggled with how to take care of my body and to also make sure that I got rest and I stretched, and so that really forced me to advance in that regard. And so I learned a lot, and I had a lot of really good people working with me and making sure that I was fully healed and recovered. And so shout out to Chris, that's my PT dude, and he did an awesome job taking care of me, and I appreciate their time and all the laughs throughout crying through the pain and the exercises. But I, like I said, I'm grateful for it. I learned a lot, and I feel really good coming into the season.
Hi, Sabrina Merchant, High Post Hoops. A lot of the players have actually mentioned like the impact of new staff, and like, I think Carly talked about a skills coach. Just what kind of energy has that brought into camp, the new faces like on the upper level here?
it's always fun getting to work with and meet new people, and I've always been a fan of Coach Fisher as a player, and to learn from him and from his experiences, it's been a blessing so far, and it's only the beginning. And so it's always helpful as in any realm of your life, whether it's basketball, the workforce, whatever you do, to get multiple perspectives and to learn from different people and how they operate. And so Dash, our player development coach, he's one of the best in the game. And so already he's been so intentional with working with us as individuals in our skill groups, and each coach brings a different dynamic, including him. And so to learn from their perspectives and to really take in their expertise and their knowledge, it's been so much fun. And they bring such great energy to the gym, and that's across the board. I mean, from people who work in the offices, and then people who work like Eli behind the scenes, like shout out to Eli. And you have Court. Write it in the articles, Eli is great. You have Kelly, you have Court, you have all these people, Thomas, you have so many people who are in this thing together. And so to bring the new coaching staff in with their personalities, how dynamic they are, and then you add the fun of the individuals within the team, it's such a blessing to be a part of it. And so like Carly had said, it's cool to learn from these new people with all the experiences and the success that they've had as coaches, as players, you name it.
Pavy here, Hoops and Brews. Question for the both of you. I know both of you played overseas. Maria, you just got here. Can you talk about the turnaround and how quick of a turnaround it is? Like, is it strenuous? Is it tiring? How is it for you guys?
Yeah, it's we have such a small window to play, and so it is really cool to be able to experience different countries, meet new people, play year-round for the most part, and then you know come back here for the summer, get to play at home in front of friends and family, and so I'm grateful for the opportunity to do it. I know that there is wear and tear on your body. As you can see, there's been a couple of injuries to superstars because of how long we go and how hard we go, but overall, I think to play the game, to play the sport, you learn, like I touched on with getting injured, you learn how to take care of yourself, you learn your limits and what you should do in order to be the best that you can when it's time to take the floor. And so that's another thing I'm grateful for our coaching staff. They're very mindful to make sure that we are rested, that we're taken care of, and they don't want to push us any harder than they have to. And so obviously you got to grind, there's things that you got to improve on. You can't skip the work, there's no substitute for it, but at the same time, it is important to balance the workload and making sure that you do take time to yourself, that you rest, that you watch Netflix shows that make you laugh, and that you enjoy the process outside of being on the court. And so, you know, when you're overseas by yourself, if you have resources for training staff, for recovery, you take advantage of those, and then just try and maintain throughout the course of each season. And then when you do have breaks, you take advantage of those too, and you just stop. And so that's one thing that I've learned is how important it is to just stop, be a person for a moment and take it in, and then once you're back on, you turn it on.
Just so you guys know, Masha won 4 championships this offseason, so I'm just going to tell you about those 4.
Yeah, we won the Euroleague. It's an important league in Europe. And we has a good staff in Russia. We has good players there. It's Brittany Griner, Kayla McBride, Wanda Schultz.
Masha.
Masha.
Masha's really good.
It was good season there. We won Russian League 2 Super Cup and Russian Cup.
That's it. Every championship possible, Masha won it.
Gio with the fantasy sports team on.